In this video, we're going to show you how to use the fx-9750G3 graphing calculator to calculate absolute values of numbers or expressions. To do so, we need to enter into the Run Matrix menu. So here's the main menu, and I want this number 1 or Run Matrix, so I'm going to hit Execute or 1, and that brings me into the calculation menu. I want to get the absolute value, so that's a math calculation. I'm going to choose F4, but before I do that, I'm going to choose the type of output, because depending on the output you've chosen, your absolute value calculations might look different. So we're going to go into Setup. So if you look above the menu, it's in yellow. I'm going to hit Shift, Setup. Oops, I forgot to hit Shift, so let's try that again. Shift, Setup. And I'm concerned about input-output, and default is math, and we're going to use that first. And math lets you see calculations in standard notation. So fractions look like fractions, and absolute value looks like an absolute value. So we're going to hit Execute. That's good. We'll come back and do linear and show you the difference. So let's do a simple absolute value calculation with a number. So I'm going to find the absolute value by going into my math calculation, so function F4, and you'll see that this is right up here under F3. It's ABS, stands for absolute. When I choose F3, I see standard notation of absolute value, and it's waiting for me to input a number. Let's input negative 45. So in standard notation, you'll see the value you're trying to find, the absolute value, inside those straight up and down brackets, standard notation. When I hit execute, it's going to give me the absolute value of that. And you can do expressions as well. Let's hit that F3 again to get my absolute value in there. Let's do 5 minus 21. So I can do an expression, and it's going to give me the absolute value of that result. And that's a positive 16. I can also do functions and expressions using variables. So I could assign a value to a variable. So let's give a variable value to x. So let's assign 5 to be the value of x. So I'm going to choose the store button here, and I'm going to choose my variable x. And when I hit execute, it's going to store that 5 in as x. So anytime I use x, it's now going to be a 5. Now let's do an absolute value calculation with a expression, with a variable expression. Again, I want to choose F3 to get that absolute value notation in there, then put what I want to find the absolute value of inside that standard. So let's say x minus 2. And I can even use my toggle button to go outside the bracket and do, you know, other operations, add, subtract, whatever. And it's going to find the absolute value of whatever's in the absolute value brackets and then multiply that by 2. And when I hit execute, it's going to give me the solution to that using the value that I assigned x. So there's very easy to use the absolute value. Let's show you now the difference if you are in linear output. We're going to hit shift, setup again, and we're going to change the input output to be linear. So F2 this time. And let's hit exit, get back. And now I want to show you the difference between absolute value here. It looks very different when you are working with it in linear. Notice, because I'm in linear input-output, I don't have those options here for math that I had before. Instead, I'm going to need to use my options here. So when I hit options, here's where I'm going to find things that I can do. And I'm looking for a type of number, an absolute value. So I'm going to use F6 to see more, and here is number. When I hit F4, there's that absolute value. I also want you to notice what happens when I hit it. Instead of seeing the standard notation, because I'm in linear output, it uses the word, and I need to make sure I use parentheses. So this makes it very different. So if I want to find the absolute value of negative 45, I need to make sure I put that negative 45 in parentheses before I then hit execute, and it's then going to find it. So the difference in linear output is you're not in standard notation, and you're going to end up having to use the words and parentheses. So if I wanted to use my variable expression, I can still do it. So let's hit F1, but I am now going to need to make sure I use parentheses, x minus 2, close my parentheses. So it's going to find the absolute value of whatever I've put in parentheses, and then it's going to do any other operations after that fact. And then we're going to hit execute. So looks very different. I personally prefer the standard notation because that's what students are going to be seeing. So you can choose whichever one you want. And simply to change it back, you hit shift menu and change back to this math. And so now we're ready to go.